Nos encontramos en Union Square, en el lugar de la convocatoria para una nueva conmemoración del 1 de mayo aquí en Chicago. Vamos a estar conversando con los asistentes para conocer sus impresiones durante la manifestación.
This is an anniversary of a very important day in the work for the world's working class. May Day came about as a result of events centered around the eight-hour day, okay, as a political movement back in the 1880s. In this city, in 1886, there was essentially an event that led to, at that time, there was some police were killed, there was a bombing. There were demonstrations for the eight-hour day. To this day, we don't know who even threw this bomb or whatever. But as a consequence, some anarchists, because that was what the movement was at that time, were arrested, and about eight of them were found guilty. Four of them were executed. One committed suicide. But it was out of that that this event became a worldwide phenomenon.
The reason I'm here because we have been in oppression for way too long. We have been an oppressed nation for way too long. It is time for us to unite and stand together.
El abuso del trabajo no solamente es con el hombre, con el inmigrante, no más con la mujer, ya que la mujer es menos pagada que el hombre. En los trabajos de las empresas multinacionales que ofrecen trabajos aquí son trabajos de miseria.
Capitalism does not value people and for what they're worth. Everyone should be paid what they're worth. And technically, there should be no money. Things should be done for the need and the betterment of society.
Hace pocos minutos se ha dado inicio a la manifestación que va a recorrer las calles de Chicago. La primera parada será en el Consulado de México, donde se va a protestar por solidaridad por la desaparición de los 43 estudiantes normalistas en Ayotzinapa.
We are indigenous. We are native. We are black, we are brown, we are white, we are united. This is not the first time that Chicago police has guarded this building and not allowed Mexican citizens to come in here.
Yeah.
To denounce the terror that we see as Mexican citizens living in Chicago, to denounce the terror that we witness in our country and also here in the city of Chicago. And we're here to let these folks know this is our street, this is our building, and we will denounce and continue to denounce. To disappear where we are.
We march through the neighborhoods to where the police brutality is. So some people are afraid to even come out and be in the streets. We march through my neighborhood. We march through some of the other young men's neighborhood, the Pilsen neighborhood, but they weren't afraid. So it's time for people to rise up and say, I'm not afraid. I want my voice to be heard.
Después de aproximadamente 3 horas de caminata, la marcha ha llegado a su fin aquí en la ciudad de Chicago. Vamos a aprovechar de conversar con algunos de los organizadores.
Unfortunately, in recent years, a lot of the trade unions in Chicago and across the country have become business unions, which are more interested in working with the state and working with the bosses to create an obedient workforce. I mean, the IWW is the industrial workers of the world. We are a union, but we are a radical anti-capitalist union. One of the reasons we wanted to start the coalition is to bring back the very important idea of workers' self-organization, so that the idea of unions is not voting for democratic candidates or letting a service come to you, but it's actually organizing yourself in your workplaces so that you can improve the conditions of your lives and control the conditions of your workplace.
So many of us have been socially indoctrinated to identify with the oppressors, not to think of ourselves as working class people. So first we have to try and raise people's level of class consciousness. And then, as we're doing that, we're also organizing for worker control at the job sites and community control in working class neighborhoods. And then once we start doing that, then we can start getting more people to these rallies and using militant direct action tactics.
California.
Esas fueron las palabras de Adolf Fischer, uno de los cuatro mártires anarquistas que fueron ejecutados en la horca aquí en la ciudad de Chicago a raíz de los sucesos ocurridos en 1886 en el marco de la huelga general que se inició el 1 de mayo. Hoy día, 129 años después, una nueva conmemoración en esta ciudad ha llegado a su fin y pareciera que la deuda con la historia es más grande que nunca.